The new WLTP procedure. In road traffic, there are primarily two types of emissions. On the one hand, the carbon dioxide output, which is directly linked to fuel consumption. On the other hand, for example, nitrogen oxide and particulate emissions. The emission standards set limit values for these pollutant emissions. There are standardized test procedures for determining the carbon dioxide output and pollutant emissions. The NEDC cycle was last revised in 1992. It is no longer suitable for a realistic evaluation of current vehicle generations. That is why the new WLTP procedure replaces the existing NEDC certification. WLTP stands for Worldwide Harmonized Light Vehicles Test Procedure. There are major differences between the WLTP and the NEDC. The WLTP cycle is based on globally determined real driving data, and for this reason is more realistic and significantly more demanding. The average speed is much higher. The route in the test cycle is more than twice as long. The maximum speed is significantly higher. Acceleration is more powerful, and the vehicle stands still less. The determination of the certification values accounts for the vehicle equipment with its effects on the mass as well as on the aerodynamic drag and the rolling resistance. This means that each vehicle can have its own certified carbon dioxide value. Due to the new test procedure, the values certified according to WLTP will be higher than the current NEDC values. In some countries, the higher certified fuel consumption may have a greater effect on the motor vehicle tax rate. Of course, the WLTP certification remains a standardized test cycle because the vehicle's actual consumption depends to a large extent on the individual driving style, on the route profile, on the traffic density, on the vehicle's load, and on the external conditions. The switch to the WLTP procedure is a major step towards more realistic fuel consumption figures and more transparency. It is taking place in several steps. Depending on the vehicle model and type of registration, the switch to WLTP is happening gradually between 2017 and 2019. In each case, the regulation will apply to vans certified as commercial vehicles 1 year after it goes into effect for vans certified as passenger vehicles. Already registered vehicles are not affected by the switch. In future, a vehicle's emissions will also be measured in real road traffic, in addition to the WLTP test on the roller dynamometer in the laboratory, where the real driving emissions, or RDE for short, are verified. The nitrogen oxide and particulate emissions are determined with the help of a portable measuring device at the rear of the vehicle. RDE is to ensure that the vehicles do not exceed the permitted limits for emissions in real daily driving on the road. The new WLTP and RDE regulations will yield even more precise and reliable measurements of carbon dioxide output and pollutant emissions in future. As a result, the new procedures will bring about more transparency. At Mercedes-Benz, we are constantly working on the technological advancement of our engines in order to reduce emissions and implement new standards. For more information, please visit our internet pages or your Mercedes-Benz dealer.